With a population of over 3 million people, the city of Athens, steeped in history, still standing amidst the modern-day bustle, together with its nearby port of Piraeus, is the economic and political heart of Greece. The economic crisis hit hard, and images of enormous protests at the Syntagma Square, seen here, traveled around the world. The ancient monuments still draw tourists in huge numbers to the city, the best known being this UNESCO World Heritage Site, the Acropolis. Outside the busy center lies the military airport of Tatoi. This is also the location of the Greek Air Force Museum, which is home to an outstanding collection of aircraft, though gaining access to it can be quite challenging, with prior permission being required. It is worth pointing out there is also a Greek Military History Museum close to the Greek Parliament, which also has a few aircraft parked outside, though the collection of the Air Force Museum is far more extensive. Probably the easiest way to see the museum is to visit during the Athens Flying Week held at Tatoi before the start of the flying display, as the museum is opposite the crowd area in the display box. A few days before, there's also a pre-show at the Athens seaside area of Phalerio, where some acts already perform in late afternoon and early evening. During the weekend of the 12th and 13th of September, it was time for the main show, held for the fourth time in 2015, and fast gaining a reputation internationally. The extensive showground has all the usual amenities to occupy the entire family. Catering is tasty and affordable, the souvlaki meriting special mention. Apart from the full-size display aircraft, there were also some model displays, including this one, which had a little surprise up its fuselage. And the flyby of this drone, which captured some aerial images of the crowd. Former occupants of the airfield, like these Grumman AtCats next to some of the current Greek aircraft based there. Let's start the support with one of these current aircraft of the Greek Air Force currently based at Tatoi, the T-41 Maskalaro. Eighteen of these T-41Ds are in service with the Hellenic Air Force Academy for basic flying training. The Maskalaro is basically a military version of the popular civilian Cessna 172 sports aircraft. Trainee pilots in the Hellenic Air Force fly the T-41 for about 19 hours during the first year of their flight training before progressing to the T-6 Texan II. Another aircraft type based at Tatoi is the Polish-built Pizetel Mielek M18 Dromader. A total of 22 M18s are in use for firefighting and observation. These replace the Grumman AtCats we saw a bit earlier in this report. The M18s are part of 351 Squadron. In the total of 22 aircraft, the Hellenic Air Force has 3 double-seaters for training purposes.
Thank you.
The next two items were also local. The Athenian Aviators Collection, an organization that restores and maintains vintage aircraft in flying condition. Here we see a fuselage torque, actually a Morand-Saulnier Criquet, as this particular aircraft was built in France in 1949. The TBY Catalina and A26 Invader we saw in the static earlier in this video also belong to the collection. The stork you see here is flown by a pilot of EADS and of the Messerschmitt Stiftung, Klaus Plaza, who has extensive experience flying classic aircraft. The fuselage stork is of course best known for its ability to fly extremely slowly, nearly hovering if the wind is right, so it can take off and land in very short distances, making it ideal for special operations in the Second World War. This aircraft wears the markings of the plane with which the German SS captain Otto Skorzeny rescued the Italian dictator Benito Mussolini. The Hellenic Air Force had one stork in service in 1946, an aircraft captured by the British forces when the Germans retreated from Greece. The Hellenic Air Force also operated the Bucher Jungmeister in the past. This was a German training aircraft from the 1930s. So it probably gained most fame as an outstanding aerobatics aircraft. This particular plane served with the Swiss Air Force for pilot training from 1937 until 1968. It was built under license by the company Dornier Werke in Alten Rhein. It is part of the Athenian Aviators Collection since 1997, when they purchased it in the United States. The Jungmeister is a single-seat development of the Bucher 131 Jungmann 2-seat training aircraft. Flying Week is a true international air show. The Italian Week Fly team is a bit special. All pilots in the team are disabled and want to serve as role models and inspiration for other people to overcome their limitations. They fly the Texan two-seater ultralight aircraft with great skill and add some excitement to their show with the use of colored smoke. Team leader is Alessandro Paleri, with Marco Cherubini on his left wing and Eric Kustacher as right wing man. Air shows couldn't exist without major sponsorship, And this EC-120 has two well-known aviation sponsors adorning its fuselage. The Lithuanian precision watchmaker Vostok Europe and Polish aviation fuel company Warter Aviation. The EC-120, nowadays of Airbus helicopters, is flown here by Dimitris Tervirelis, nicknamed the Wizard. He was the first Greek to perform a televised looping with a helicopter. He used to fly with the Hellenic Army Special Operations and went on to gain his commercial helicopter license in the United States and founded the company Greek Helicopters. The EC-120 can seat up to 5 people and is in service both in the military and civilian around the world, including for military helicopter pilot training for the Spanish, French and Belgian air forces. Another well-known brand in the world of aviation is Swiss chronographer Breitling. Here we see them as sponsors on the XR330SC, flown by Frenchman Michael Brago, part of the French aerobatics team at international competitions and of the Challenger Cup of the Red Bull Air Race World Series. The XR330 is the latest aerobatics aircraft to come from Walter Extra Aircraft in Germany. These are the Red Bull Shepherd model gliding team from Austria, flying a similar demonstration as their true-size Danish gliders Austrian compatriots. And more Red Bull, in combination with the sponsorship of Watchmaker Citizen, seen on the Swift S1 glider of Luca Bertossio. Luca has won several gold medals in the FAI World Gliding Championships, even at his young age of 25. Here's the Italian blue chip jet team, flying 4 FL-100s. FL is short for the company Fly Latino. The pilots in the team are all ex-Italian Air Force pilots. The leader is Ciccio Martone, right wingman is Tommaso Raponi, left wingman Gianfranco Ciotto, and the sole pilot is Bruno Servade. The FL-100 is an Italian-built ultralight, manufactured in the city Latina. The aircraft can perform loopings and rolls without problem, allowing Bucirci to put on a varied and elegant demonstration with their ultralights. Thank you. Here's world-renowned unlimited aerobatics legend Jurgis Kairys in an SU-31, sponsored by Vostok Europe, just like the EC-120 earlier in this report. He helped develop the Sukhoi SU-31 and other Sukhoi aerobatics aircraft like the SU-26 and SU-29. He's a Lithuanian, but was actually born in Siberia back in 1952. He won several gold medals in World Championship aerobatics competitions in the 1990s. The SU-31 is a single-seat variant of the SU-29 and has a more powerful engine than that aircraft, plus a new undercarriage. It first flew back in 1992 and can take up to minus 10 and plus 12 G. Here is Johan Gustafsson in his SZD-59 acroglider. Johan hails from Dalajarna in central Sweden. For his day job, he works as a mechanical engineer, but his spare time is dedicated to his passion for flying, something he's been doing since the age of 15. It's a passion he shares with his father, who is also a pilot. The glider he uses is the SZD-59. This aircraft was built in Poland in 2005 and weighs a mere 270 kilograms, thanks to its light fiberglass materials. It is capable of withstanding +7 and -5G and a roll rate of 100 degrees per second, very impressive for a glider. Johan has taken part in gliding and aerobatics competitions in Sweden and internationally and has so far performed very well with several medals in both categories. Here you see Rex Pemberton from Australia starting his descent with his wingsuit, and immediately his wife Melissa from the United States starts barrel rolling around him in her Zivco Aeronautics H540. Both of them love extreme sports like skydiving, and Rex is an experienced mountaineer, having climbed all 7 highest summits in the world. Melissa aims to serve as a role model for girls across the world to chase their dreams. No dream is too big or impossible to achieve. She is a member of the US aerobatics team and came in third place at the World Championship Aerobatics at Chaturu in 2015. Thanks must go to Melissa and Rex for sharing their stunning onboard footage for this video. Keep an eye out for the low-level aerobatics at the end of her solo demonstration after Rex lands, which includes a ribbon cut. After the civilian displays at the Athens Flying Week 2015, it's time to look at the military participants at the show, starting with the first of two Polish Air Force acts to perform over the weekend, the popular MiG-29 solo demonstration run by Captain Adrian Rojek. The MiG-29 grew out of a requirement of the former Soviet Union to counter the threat posed by the American F-15 and F-16s in the 1970s, which were both designed as agile fighters. The design bureau Mikoyan Gurovich designed this aircraft with conventional control, as opposed to the fly-by-wire found in, for instance, the F-16 and F-18. Its agility is impressive, as demonstrated with this tail slide. The MiG-29 first flew in 1983 and was later exported to other nations of the former Warsaw Pact. Since then, it has undergone several upgrades, most notably to enhance weapons ergonomy for the pilot, which is definitely the case with the Polish MiG-29s to bring them into line with NATO standards. This aircraft is part of one ELT based at Minsk Mazowiecki near Warsaw. The Polish Air Force also has a second MiG-29 based at Malbork in northern Poland. Note the special paint scheme on this aircraft, which includes the badge of one ELT on top of the fuselage and the picture of Polish World War II pilot Eugenius Arbuszewski on the inside of the tail fins, paying tribute to fallen war heroes. Here's the second Polish Air Force display at the show, the aerobatic team Orlik from the Polish Air Force Academy at Radom. Flies the PZL-130 Orlik turboprop trainer. This aircraft is a Polish design. The first version of this aircraft was severely underpowered, which led to the decision to change its engine for a turboprop. Team Orlik was formed in 1998 and is one of two official Polish Air Force aerobatic teams, the other team flying the Iskra jet trainer. Team leader is Captain Dariusz Staszurski. Like the other team members, he combines his teamwork with instructor duties at the Polish Flight Academy. We'll be right back. A third form of flying display at the Athens Flying Weekend, the Belgian Air Force F-16 solo display, flown by senior captain Tom de Morto, callsign Gizmo, who kindly provided the spectacular onboard footage you can see in this report. The F-16 is the Belgian Air Force's main fighter aircraft and has been in service since 1979, albeit with several upgrades along the way, making it more powerful and more technologically advanced than it already was at the start of its career. The aircraft is fly-by-wire, which means it is controlled by computers interpreting the pilot's input on the stick, not hydraulically like with the MiG-29 we saw earlier. This means the computer can take the aircraft to the limit without ending up in a dangerous situation outside the flight envelope. Gizmo is part of 31 Tiger Squadron, based at the Air Force Base Kleine Brogel. During his demonstration, Gizmo goes up to 9G, but also performs negative G maneuvers like this outside turn. And here the high-speed pass, just below the speed of sound. Here Gizmo performs a slow spiral descent, beautifully accentuated by the smoke winders at the wingtips, producing a nice thick smoke trail, so the crowd can follow the aircraft more easily. Like the Polish Air Force displays before him, Gizmo didn't operate from Tatoi, but from the nearby airbase of Tanagra. Thank you. and hear a final salute to the public before he returns to Tanagra. Back to the Greek military then, starting with the Hellenic Navy, showcasing this S-70B Aegean Hawk and an AB-212. These helicopters will present an airborne helicopter assault with troop insertion. While the AB-212 provides fire cover for the S-70B, troops descend using the fast roping method. The Hellenic Navy ordered 11 S-70B Aegean Hawks, the Greek version of the Seahawk. The S-70 is considered to be among the most advanced naval helicopters in the world. Its tasks include anti-submarine and anti-shipping missions. It can carry anti-shipping missiles and torpedoes, plus other anti-submarine weapons. The AB-212 is a variant of the well-known UH-1 the UH Army used in enormous numbers during the Vietnam War. You can see the machine gun hanging from the side to provide fire support for these airborne assaults, but it also performs anti-submarine warfare. The AB-212 is built under license by Augusto Bell from Italy. Seven are assumed to be still in service with the Hellenic Navy. Hear a patriotic salute by the AB-212. Both the AB-212 and the S-70 are based at Marathon.
wszystkiego, jak nie przekwedeć, to mi tam skolię, to teraz na tygu, ale my się nie jest już programatyjskie, to mi determinaj, to teraz na tygu.
Following the Saturday assault demonstration, the S-70 stayed at Tatoi to join the static park. Time for the Hellenic army then, which was present at Tatoi with their Apache display team called Pegasus. The Hellenic army has a mix of H-64A+ and H-64D longbow models of this attack and anti-tank helicopter in service, an order of 29 in total. The first Apaches entered service with the Hellenic army in 1995. Unlike the Dutch Apache demonstration, Pegasus shows off the agility at low level, illustrating the tight turning capability of the aircraft. Pegasus performs its show with an AH-64A+ model. Like all Hellenic Apaches, this Pegasus helicopter is stationed at Stefanovikion, about halfway between Larissa and Volos. The helicopter they use is a standard helicopter, also in standard camouflage scheme. The color emblems you see on this Apache are stickers they applied at the show itself, and which were removed before returning to their home base. On both days, a pair of F-4E Phantoms, upgraded to AUP standard, made two passes, much to the delight of the audience, as Phantoms are becoming a rare sight at European air shows. Then came a relatively local dogfight demonstration, two Hellenic Mirage 2000 EGs from nearby Tanagra, the airbase most of the military participants operated from. Together with the F-16s, the Mirage 2000s guard the Greek skies against hostiles, performing intercept duties regularly. The Hellenic Air Force ordered 44 Mirage 2000s, which are based at Andravida and Tanagra. Apart from interception, they have a secondary anti-shipping role. First of the two Hellenic Air Force official demo teams of the show was Daedalus with the T-6 Texan II. On Saturday it passed by with the Dash 8 Q400 of Olympic Airways. Trainee pilots would graduate from the Cessna T-41 we saw earlier progress to this Texan II aircraft for their advanced training. The Hellenic Air Force ordered 45 of these Beechcraft T-6s and they are based at Kalamata. Team Daedalus was established in 2005 and was trained by the then official United States Air Force T-6 demonstration team. Finally, we look at the Hellenic Air Force demonstration team Zeus with the F-16C Fighting Falcon, seen here passing information with an Aegean airline Boeing 737. Team Zeus uses an F-16C Block 52 Plus aircraft, which is equipped with conformal fuel tanks, giving it an extended range and beefier appearance. As you can see here, the aircraft also wears quite an attractive paint scheme. The F-16 is the front line of the Hellenic Air Force, hence why the team carries the name of Zeus, the father of the Olympian gods in ancient Greek mythology. Flying the F-16 here is Captain Sotiros Stralis of 340 Squadron, based at Chania or Souda Bay on the island of Crete. Thank you. flown more than 1700 hours, 1300 of which on the F-16. Like Team Daedalus, Team Zeus was trained by the United States Air Force demonstration team back in 2009, and performed its first public display in 2010. Zeus, we conclude our look at the 2015 Athens Flying Week at Tatoi Airbase, a rare opportunity to admire a variety of Greek aircraft. Blessed with warm weather, the audience got to discover various aspects of aviation, which no doubt leaves them hungry for more. In 2016, the Athens Flying Week will be held on 17th and 18th of September at Tatoi.